Hi, thanks for joining me on today's review and analysis of the new swing dancing documentary Alive and Kicking. Earlier today, I had the opportunity to sit down with Susan Glatzer, the writer-director of the documentary, as well as Norma Miller. Now, she is the queen of swing dance and, in fact, is one of the originators of the Lindy Hop. So I will definitely share that with you, but before we do, a quick synopsis. Alive and Kicking is a walk through the history of swing dancing up to present day, as told by some of the original Lindy Hoppers and current swing dancing elite. There is definitely a lot to learn from Alive and Kicking. If you don't know about swing dancing, this is the place to go to find out. I learned so many interesting facts. Now, a couple of the most interesting to me were that dances like the Lindy Hop actually originated in Harlem. I had no idea. Another fact is that dances, the competition, is not the be-all and end-all for swing dancers, and that's not where the big money is the way it is in ballroom dance, and that's because so much of a swing dance competition is actually improvised. You don't know, apparently, what music will be played, and you don't know when you'll be the one called out onto the middle of the dance floor, so the swing dancing competitions are actually used to rack up titles and get better teaching jobs, because unlike forms of dancing like ballroom dancing, the real money in swing dance is from teaching, so really fascinating. The other thing that I really took away from the movie is that Lindy Hop and swing dance in particular are just a way to bring people together. It's cross-cultural, it's cross-generational, and it has special meaning for Susan Glatzer herself because she's been a dancer for 18 years.
Well, I think what the dance and the music means is it's a way for people to come together where they can put aside whatever problems are going on in their lives and get together with people on a human level, human connection. The music itself is so happy and uplifting, the dance is so happy and uplifting, that you can forget about your troubles.
Just get happy.
Exactly. And even if it's just for a couple of hours, it's like that pressure valve. You know, we need to find a release for the troubles that we have in society today. I mean, we are so fractured as a country. We are distrustful of other people in other states, people who hold different opinions. And now if you go to Facebook, they'll tell you everything. This is how I feel about this, and this is how I feel about that. And you know, you look at that and you think,
everybody lives by Facebook.
Yeah, and you think, God, I never want to talk to that person, or I never want to go out and, you know, do anything. But then you meet them, and you think, what a lovely person. Maybe we disagree about some things, but I think you're a lovely person and a lovely individual, and we're not doing that today.
They're not?
No, I think a lot of people sit at home and, you know, isolate. I mean, you're lucky, you're a dancer. You go out and you do things and you see people, but so many people today, they isolate. They go to work and they come home and they get on their devices.
Are we talking about the 2017?
Yeah.
That's what's wrong with the world today. This is what you're saying.
Well, I'm not saying it's what's wrong with
the world
today.
Aren't that what you're saying?
I think it is a problem that people don't go out and meet each other. Mm-hmm.
That's what Frankie said, go dancing.
Go dancing.
That's and that's what's so nice, the dance can bring everyone together. Now, so much of a documentary comes together in the editing suite. So was there a storyline or a story in particular that you were really sad to have to say goodbye to?
Oh, there's so many. To know that there are DVD extras and that there will be a life for some of these things that are so wonderful, but it just didn't fit. We don't have West Coast swing in the film, but we do have it in our DVD extras. It's a wonderful form of swing dance. But it just didn't fit into the story that we were telling.
Got Balboa in there also?
We're showing Balboa. Uh-huh. The movie's going to show in San Francisco. Guess what the name of the theater is?
Balboa?
Yeah.
Well, that's where the dance come from.
Yeah.
That's Sylvia and Jonathan.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why they named it Balboa.
That's right.
It had nothing, the Balboa was the shack.
You are a living history
buff. I'm a historian on dance.
Absolutely.
Oh, definitely. I know every dancer that came in from 1926. The Shag came to the Savoy in 1938. The first Lindy Hop contest that went out was 1937, and that was Ethel Waters, and that's how we made our first movie. That started in 1937. Every year something happened until Pearl Harbor.
Well, clearly you also don't suffer fools lightly. So when you two first met, what was that first meeting like?
She was filming the workshop.
No, the first time I met you before I started filming, and I was just in awe.
What were you doing?
I was just a dancer. It was in New
Orleans.
I never
saw you on...
No, you don't remember me. You don't remember me back then.
Wait a minute. New Orleans, I'm always there in July. I'm there with Louis Armstrong.
Oh, okay. It was an event, and you had one of your books was coming out, and I got you to sign the book. Okay. And I just thought that, you know, I couldn't even talk when I first met you.
Okay, well...
Well, one of the things that I love that you said in the documentary is that you enjoy teaching, but you don't teach newbies.
No, well I'm not good at it. I'm just not good at it. I was asked by one of the dancers, his name was Ryan Francois. Norma, we would rather you not teach. I'm not very good at that, and I realize I'm not. And I offend more people than ever, so that's the reason I don't teach, because I'm the person that will tell you the truth, and it's not good when you're a teacher, you know. You have to compromise, and I was never good at that.
I admit I have two left feet, but I couldn't let an opportunity go by to learn some swing dancing moves directly from the experts featured in this documentary. Kim Clever and David Frutos have won numerous titles together and are even in the California Swing Dance Hall of Fame. Now, having good teachers makes dancing surprisingly easy to follow. Of course, we weren't doing anything too complicated, but they were fantastic. Have you seen Alive and Kicking yet? Did it make you want to get up and dance as much as I did? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe. And until next Monday, have a great week at the movies.